No sound? Oh, okay. Sorry. Okay. No sound. Have we got sound now? Okay. Have we got sound now? Is sound okay? Hello? Hello? Are we good? Oh, bugger. Okay, cool. Okay, sorry about that. Can I just say hello to everyone again? Oh my gosh. G'day Cherry, hello. G'day Suju, hello. Hello Janice. Hello Dee, Nolani. G'day Angie, my dear. Turn your volume up. It's up now. Nanette, hello, hello. Okay, all right. Bloody hell. Okay, I mean, what's this? Her first minute and a half could be, what is it? Considered an Oscar performance of the silent movie genre. Just a quick pop in to say hello before I leave to conduct a workshop. Yes, loud and clear. Okay, Louise, thank you so much. Hello, Ali. Hello, how are you going? All right, getting with the program. Okay, this is what I was saying before. Oh my gosh. Okay, so I need to do this mushroom. What I was saying before is that I'm busting to do her. That didn't come out right. I'm busting to paint her. Oh, Dino. Hello, my darling. This is a very surreal art session. Oh, hello, sweetheart. Thank you so much for the super chat. You are such a sweetie. Say hello to everyone for me. All right. Gotcha. I know what you mean. Okay. Sweetheart, aren't you? Okay, so yes, I've been busting to paint this lady here, but I can't. I've got to be patient. So I've got all of these bits and pieces. So let's get with the program. I do have, and I'm going to have to cover this bit up a little bit, and this, or maybe just this area. And just this so I can put my pans on there. And as we know, it doesn't, I can do this and it doesn't affect the area, so that's fine. I'm hoping that everyone is well and everyone's had a really, really good week. What can I say? I've had so much going on. Some I could probably talk about and some I can't, but, you know, it's all good stuff. You know, it's all good stuff. So, all is well so far. Suju says, so nice to have you in my year as I finish transcribing some 1916 war letters because my week was long and hard and painful due to dental work. I hate the dentist. Well, not that I hate dentists. I don't like having stuff done to my teeth. It's expensive too. Hard and painful. Yep. Work as I am behind. Okay. All right. Hello, sweetheart. Oh, Uncle. No, it's not. It's my Uncle Dave. It's Uncle Dave. I've got to tell you. Hubby Dave is, Hubby Dave is named after his uncle, David Murray here. I thought it was Hubby, and I'm thinking, that's strange. I just saw him a moment ago, but it's Uncle Dave. Hello, Uncle Dave. How you going? We want to come and visit you soon. So nice to see ya. Nice to see ya. Okay. All right. Get with the program, Chrissy. Let's go. Let's go, baby, go. All right. I mean, how long? Okay. Well, it's been about 5 minutes. It's not as bad as 20 minutes me carrying on without doing any artwork. So I hope everyone's week has been really well. You know what I realized? You know what? I don't know about you, but around where I live, and I'm really interested to see if that's happened to you all, the Christmas decorations are starting to come up. And commercials on TV are talking about Christmas gifts and stuff like that. Is that happening across the other side of the world? Are we talking about Christmas already? And I mean, surely. I mean, well, I know we're close, but honestly. So, you know, I wonder if everyone else is having the same situation. I mean, Ali says, Chrissy, I don't know why Auralin is rated high light fastness in watercolour by art companies, but it is technically fugitive. Is that a yellow? Is that a yellow? No. Oh gosh. Sometimes I don't know all my names, so I'm going to ask for forgiveness if I've got this wrong. I don't know all the names to the pigments. I know a few, but not all. Okay, my son put up his Christmas tree on Halloween. There you go. There you go. See what I mean? Yeah. Sergio says, Chrissy, in other news, guess who started making his own water... I heard. Your... Oh. Oh, bugger. I heard that you're doing that. That must be exciting. Making your own pigments. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, depends on... Yeah, there we go. I'm over Christmas already. There you go, Uncle Dave. Jeez. Well, I haven't put a Christmas tree up. And the only way I'll put a Christmas tree up if the grandkids come. because hubby Dave is... I call him Scrooge sometimes because, you know, I go, bah, humbug. I want to put decorations up. And he's going, ah. Oh. He carries on, but yeah. So is this where he gets it from you, Uncle Dave? Sergio says depends on the pigment. There are Auralin hues which are generally made, yeah, yellow. It's PY. I thought it was yellow. It is yellow. The genuine, yeah, cobalt yellow is one of, yeah. I thought it was yellow. Yeah, so, whew, got that one right. I mean, I don't know all the names. That's the thing. I did at one time, I thought to myself, well, I've actually got some pigments as well, to make some paint, but I haven't been that adventurous, yet. I suppose it's because there's so much going on in my life. You know, good things. I'm just trying to squeeze in the time to do all the things that interest me. And like, I love experimenting, and that would be one of them. Yes. Nanette says, I probably won't put up a tree this year. I have two kittens. Oh yeah. Could you imagine them playing around with the balls? You know, they'd be, yeah, you wouldn't have any balls, would you? Or balls. Christmas decorations. Why do I say it like that? I mean, it's good in here, but when it comes out, it's bad. Ali says, Chrissy and Sergio, Holbein watercolor Auralin is the coolest to the Auralin in tone and color and with light fastness. Oh, I'm loving this conversation. I love all of this. I love this stuff. Keep it coming, Ali. Keep it coming. Because we want to be taught as well. Okay, and Cherry says, good idea. Our old cat ran up the middle of ours when she came, when she was a kitten. Oh my gosh. Well, I'm going to get a dog. And I know I talk about it every live stream, bloody hell. But I'm getting more and more excited because hubby has... given me permission to have it, because it's a big deal to have a pet. Like, do you know what I mean? Like, I have to I think I have to be trained more than the dog, to be honest. That's how. And plus, it would be nice for a dog to keep me company when I'm painting, you know, so yeah, looking forward to that. We're trying to make our house pet safe. And that takes a bit of, you know, a bit of doing. And not only that, they're bloody expensive. I don't know, like, we're talking in the thousands, okay? We're not talking in the hundreds, Aussie dollars, I'm saying. You know, how is it that they're charging so much for, like, cats and dogs? Like, it can be 6,000, it could be 10,000, depending on the breed. thinking, oh, you know. And I know that there's ones at the shelter. I get that too. Like, we have what's called the RSPCA, and we can go to get a pet from the shelter. Yes, we can do that. But it's a particular breed that I want. Nat, you don't have balls. Okay. That's fine. Oh, Uncle Dave, what sort? Okay, I want to get a miniature schnauzer. You know, I like the big moustache, you know, and the eyebrows, the furry eyebrows. Yeah, I want one of those. And will we be able to bring our dog if we came to visit you? That's what I wanted to ask as well. Because you know what? When you've got a dog, you just can't go off and leave it, you know, things like that. So we'd have to go to places where they were dog friendly, I suppose, or put it in a kennel if we're going away for a while. Okay. Okay. All right, Uncle Dave. You'll vote for that. Fantastic. Angie says, I can't do any more pets. The heartache of losing them is too much. Yes, I know. But I've never had a dog in my life. Like, I'm talking in my life. How is that possible? I haven't. Sergio says, Ali, because it is made of three different yellow pigments, mostly azo, and, oh gosh, benzimidazolines, which are very neutral, slightly warmish yellow, great transparency as well, but they lack texture. Interesting. Of course you can. We are dog friendly. Thank you. That's good. Okay, Angie says, I will love them. Oh, yes, I know I will. See, I know what's going to happen. I'm the major carer of the dog, but I can imagine hubby Dave would be, he would probably be issuing the discipline with the dog, I reckon. Although dogs or pets seem to love him, they gravitate towards him. You know, he is a bit of a grumpy bum, hubby, sometimes. So, but he is a dear, you know. All right. So, okay. Okay, Cherry says, it's like having another young child. There you go. See, that's it. Well, I suppose, you know, the last of the kids have gone, and I'm probably having a bit of a there's a bit of a void, I suppose. I think that's probably what's happening, is that there's a void. Yes, definite. So I hope you're liking my magic mushrooms. Bit weird, but anyway, that's fine. Yeah. And plus the dog that I want, I don't want it to shed. You know, I don't want it to shed. I'd be forever picking up fur, wouldn't I? I'd be forever doing that. Okay. All right. Okay. I hope, and Janice says, I hope you can have the dog house trained before you get out. That's a lot of work. Yeah, see, that's why the owner has to be trained, I think. And I'm going to go to doggy school and the whole thing. And I'm going to do take out pet insurance and stuff like that, because, you know, everyone's talking about vet bills and stuff like that. And I'm thinking, I think that's something that I've got to consider as well. So there's all of that. So I've got to be prepared for all of that stuff. So being responsible. Yeah. Okay, Nan says, Chrissy, you will forever Yeah, I know. Picking up poop all the... Yes, I know. I have got this in my head. I've also considered that. Yes. Yes. Well, you know. Yes. You know, there's always good points and bad points. I wonder if I could make a little special grass patch for the dog to go to. A bit like a kitty litter thing. You know what I mean? I could do that, couldn't I? Is that possible? Can you do that? I had that in my head, but I suppose that's not to be. I don't know. That's all right. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, so yes, I have to be trained. And I think that's half of the problem too. If you let your pet get away with things, I mean, it doesn't understand. It's a child. It's almost like it's like a child. You know, it doesn't understand. You need to help it a little bit. Okay. Buy a master SQ imitation grass from Bunnings. Oh, can I do that? Can I do that? Oh, okay. Have you got one? Have you got that, Uncle Dave? Have you got that? And it doesn't work. Abigail, hello, how you going? How you going? Nice to see you here. Nan says, yeah, and watch the dog become more attached to hubby than you watch. That is what's going to happen. Oh yeah, so yeah, Janice says, yeah, her husband will be forever picking up the poop. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. And yeah, it will, because dogs love Dave. They love Dave. Angelina, hello, my darling. How you going? Oh, Chrissy, did you get a dog in the end? No, I'm getting a dog. I'm gonna get one. I'm gonna get one. God willing. God willing. We're just fixing, making sure that our property is suited for a pet. You know, the doggy doors, the gates. You know, we've got a pool area, so we've got to sort of, you know, if got to fix that area. I mean, we've got gates for children and stuff like that, but it's not dog proof. You know, you might have to, particularly if it's a pup. I don't know what we're going to get, if it's going to be a pup or not, but we'll see. Time will tell when the time is right. But yes, yeah. Okay, no, my dog. Okay. Okay, D says we had a specific area. Oh, yeah. We had a specific area for one of our dogs we got as a pup, and no duties on walks. Oh, sorry, I'm gonna start again. Okay, we had a specific area for one of our dogs we got as a pup, and no duties on walks. Went out before and after walk to their space. Wow. And that's what I mean. It's like a toilet, isn't it? Like it goes to its toilet. You got to train it, I think. Sergio says, Chrissy, I just realized pan pastels are assigned pigment codes. Yes, they are. Yeah, they are. Yeah. As well on the, yes, on the, as well on the label. I think they might be one of the few non-painted related supplies that disclose such precious info. Yes, and I'll tell you something. Here it is here. See, there we go. PY83. And you know what? There's so much pigment in these. Like I look. Pan Pastel do not pay me to say anything or use their products or anything like that. But they're highly pigmented, very little binder. or minimum binder. That's why some of them are really vibrant. Oh, we've got a few blokes in here. Here we go. Hello, Steve. How are you going? The boys are coming in. Okay. I believe we are to be caretakers of the creatures, big and small. It, for me, is a blessing. Absolutely, absolutely. And Rob, g'day, mate. Hello. Don't forget to hit... Oh, my God, aren't you a sweetheart? Thank you so much for that. Thank you so much. Yeah, so there you go. There's, like, heaps of pigment info. Hang on, let me just turn this over. I knew this was going to happen here. There we go. PV23 for the pigment watches. And you can see the amount of stars, how... the light fastness and stuff like that. Yeah, they've got so much information on that. Oh, yeah, a terrific amount of information. Hang on. Yeah. Yeah. Ah, my dear. Okay. Yeah, now when I say blokes or, I mean gentlemen. Like, I hope for those who don't understand what I mean, because sometimes, like, I might be misunderstood, but it's a good thing. They're good words. Okay. Sergio says, Chrissy, that's interesting. That pigment PY83 is fugitive in watercolor if very diluted. Shouldn't be a problem with pastels, as they are full of pigment and least amount of binder. Yes, I agree. Brenda, hello, my darling, how you going? Hello, Chrissy, great, you are getting a dog. Get a small dog, easy to take with you anyway. Yes, well, that's why it's going to be a miniature schnauzer. And I know it was probably about, I think they're about 40 centimeters high, which is 12 inches, what's another 12 inches? Probably about, for those imperial, about 16 inches high, thereabouts. Yeah, 40 centimeters high, they're not terribly big and tall. Okay. Sorry, my watercolor journey turned me into a pigment nerd. I know, that's okay. That's where I learnt about pigments when I was learning about watercolor. I think it makes you do that. I don't understand how that happens, but yes. Yeah, and I suppose, you know what, it could be the tubes, because all that information, it's like, for example, if you're oil painting or the acrylic painters and stuff like that, all of that information is on, usually, is on the tube. So that's where I learn that kind of stuff. And then you end up looking it up, don't you? But that's, yeah. Yeah. What's this? Nan, your cat stepped right into a blob of gouache the other night. He's a Russian blue. It was blue paint. Oh, my gosh. What do you do with things like that? Like, that's really interesting. I wonder. You know, when you're painting and stuff like that, and if they, you know... Then they just sort of, particularly with the cats, because they'll come up on the table and they'll probably, you know, on your painting table, and then they start to get paint all over them. So what happens there? Like, that's interesting. Okay, I'm painting a Christmas tree now. Oh, wonderful, Brenda. That's lovely. That's lovely. And Steve says... and Rob says, okay, Ali says, Chrissy, I wish Daniel Smith made acrylics again. They discontinued them, which is sad because they had a unique pigment in their range. Well, they're a very good brand, aren't they? Oh, Daniel Smith is such a very good brand of watercolor. They make so many colors too. They've got a really huge range. Daniel Smith. So do Sennelier. So do Schmincke. Oh my gosh, I can't name them all, but the ones that I do have, I know about. Yeah. 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 Okay, Abigail says, I heard that pan pastel is much worse than gouache. It took 3 weeks to come off. Oh, really? And Nan says, I was there when it happened. Grabbed the cat and cleaned the paw. Gosh. See, they're like little kids, aren't they? You know what I mean? Like, they when they you catch them doing something that they're not supposed to be doing. Okay. Hello, Marcy. Hello. Nice to see you there, darling. How's it going? You're not late. You're good. You're good. And Brenda says, tub of towels will clean all kinds of stuff. Okay. Well, then, you know, these are all the things that I need to know. Daniel Smith came up with water-soluble oil paint now. Ah, okay. Yeah, I haven't touched on that, the water-soluble oils. Sergio says, Chrissy, Daniel Smith is a good brand, but their PR is a disaster. Maybe their PR is, maybe they do a lot of that in the US, maybe. But we don't get much of it here. I haven't seen it here, but yes. I mean, I see the products in the shops, of course, in the art stores, but... Jelena says, it was fun seeing seeing the watercolour. I know. You started, it was you, Jelena, that got us all going. Oh, gosh. I'm too scared to ask about any other collection, so I'm not going to go there. But yes, it was really interesting. Interesting watercolour collections. And it's good to know that I'm not the only crazy one that's just bought like truckloads. Ali says, Chrissy, the Daniel Smith unique pigments that no other brand did were quinacridone. I know how to say it, but I can't say it right now. Quinacridone pink PV42, quinacridone purple PV55, I love Moonglow. I've got Moonglow, and Moonglow has a lovely, it's got, it's granulating and it has a different color. There are a few different colors when you move it. I love Moonglow. Potter's Pink, not light fast. I know this much. Sells this color in their acrylic. Yeah, Potter's Pink. Yeah, those, all the pinks, the pigment, the light fastness is not all that crash hot, but they're beautiful colors. You know what I mean? So, yes, Jelena, it was fun, wasn't it? Yes, it was. Sergio says, Chrissy, I am talking about their their Primatech watercolor, okay, range scandal. Basically, the paint didn't contain the neutral mineral pigments they were labeled with, and they couldn't offer an explanation. Okay. Cherry says to Jelena, mine was the largest. Okay. I think you're being, I don't know. Abigail says, I didn't show all my watercolors because I was too lazy to collect it all from all the corners in the house. I have to say that I'm probably guilty of that too, Abigail, but I was just too embarrassed to show you what else I have. Marcy says, Chrissy, I've been asked to do a graphite portrait. I'm going to use tonal grey multimedia paper. What type of white pencil would you recommend with graphite? Or should I talk with them? Or should I talk them into charcoal? Well, I mean, you could use an eraser. I see a lot of. I've got to admit, I don't use graphite much, but I know. Of course, I know how to do it, yeah? Only because I love colour. But something like this, when you want to do highlights, is really good. Using an eraser or the Tombow eraser to get the whites in. If you wanted to get white, I mean, a white coloured pencil might not be the right choice because the graphite and that... the core of a coloured pencil probably wouldn't mix. But if you wanted to go light, I would be using an eraser if they wanted graphite. But then you could talk them into going charcoal. Well, that's so easy then, because there is white charcoal. Interesting. That's an interesting question. Interesting question. Okay, is Nior here? Hello, Nior. How are you going? Nice to see you here. Chandri, hello, my darling. How are you going? Nice to see you. I hope you are well. I hope you're okay. Sergio says, Chrissy, Potter's pink is a dull, brickish pink. Highly granulating. Potter's pink? Is it Potter's pink? Light fast. Okay. Then I'm sorry if I'm wrong. I'm sorry. Highly light fast. Are you sure? With Potter's pink? Is it Potter's? Which pink is it? There's a pink that... Or is it the fuchsia, like the fuchsia pink is the one that's not light fast? I think it's the fuchsia one that's not light fast. I think that's what it is. Yeah. Okay, Sergio says, okay, Marcy, I would suggest a white coloured pencil, there you go, such as Derwent Drawing or Luminance for the crispest of highlights. As for dull and blended highlights, white charcoal, but do not combine them. Yeah, so this is what I mean. This is what I thought of. You might have to leave the whites white and do something there. So you don't mix them. White charcoal can be used with graphite, I think, but I'm not 100% sure, says Rob. Jelena says, okay, I've decided to resist buying watercolors for now. Just don't think I'll get on with them. You know, I said that too, Cherry, but that didn't stop me. But I got there in the end. Seriously. I'm going to get my gouache out and paint, but I don't know what to paint. Ooh, paint mushrooms. That's what you've got to do. Paint mushrooms. That's what you've got to do. The reason why I say paint mushrooms is when you're trying a new medium, they're such a cute little subject where, you know, it's not complicated, and then you can you can concentrate more on the medium than you do on the actual piece. That's why I say that. And that's how I decided that I was going to do the watercolors. I go, you know what? This is a simple little project that will help me concentrate on the medium rather than the subject. So I think that's what you should do. That's a suggestion anyway. Sergio says, Chrissy, I'm very sure. Okay, all right, Potter's Pink. I have it on my palette, Chrissy. Okay, all right. We'll send you swatches after the stream. Opera Pink is not light fast in watercolour. That's what I'm thinking of. Opera Pink. You might be thinking, yes, this is what I was thinking of. Yes, so thank you for clarifying. Thank you. Appreciate that. Okay, you're going well, Chandri. 90, taking away. They are 99% taking away my right to go to art stores and all fun stores. Oh, there's always online shopping, you know. Steve says, yes. With Rob. I missed something with Rob. Yes. Here we go. Steve says, yes, it can be, but Rob, but no one doesn't go well over the top of the other. Don't remember which, yeah. Okay, thank you, Chrissy. Sergio, yep, no. I can layer the Derwent on top. Or should I go light to dark? Well, with graphite, you've got, the graphite artist, the graphite king artist is in the chat. So that would be Sergio. There you go. Sergio says, you could, but they would combine in a muddy gray. I would suggest erasing the graphite underneath. There you go. Well, this is what I was thinking. I was thinking, you know, something like that. Okay, Julian says, good idea. Maybe turn it into something else if I get carried away. Yeah. Well, it's all about the medium too. Like if you don't know what to... And plus, it gets... If you draw something simple to begin with, you get in the... if you've been losing your mojo, like you get in a bit of a rhythm. And so that's how I... That's what I do. Yeah, that's what I do. Love you too, Sergio. Moon Glow is not light fast, I think, but it's a beautiful color. Oh, it is beautiful. I'd pull it out from one of my watercolors, but they're sort of too far away from me at the moment and I can't get to it. But yes. Okay. I just wanted to, if I could bring up Share Your Art with Xrissart. That is our Facebook for people who are just who are just stumbling onto me, and all of us. Share Your Art with Xrissart is a is our Facebook group where we continue the conversation and where we lead each other to buying more and more art supplies when we find deals, and it's more or less sharing your art, sharing some wonderful art articles, sharing other artists, sharing if you've got an Instagram page or if you've done something special, you share, you know, that, whatever it may be. The rules are simple, more or less just respecting each other. So you're quite welcome to become a member one of the admins or myself will approve you as soon as we can. Yes, so there's that. And the description, it's in the links are in the description box below. Shandri says, you don't like online shopping. The color is never what it is in real life. Yes, I know. I need to see the stuff and be able to compare in real life. And probably, you want to look at it, don't you? You just want to, you want to look at it. Juliet, maybe paint a winter scene, says Cherry. Well, there's an idea. I like that. Angelina says, I have moon glow. Didn't know it was not life fast when I bought it. Juliana, and I didn't know either, to be honest. Abigail says, Chrissy, the name should be changed to share your art and enable your supplies. Well, we have a lot of enablers in here, don't we? Yes, we do. We have enablers in here. And I'm not the only one. Abigail, you're one of them. And one of our other friends who, everyone here is an enabler. As soon as you find a really good deal, you know. And I'm glad you share. I like it. I like it a lot. I like that you share that stuff. It is cool. Yeah. Ali says, Chrissy, a light fast alternative would be to replace anthraquinone red PR177 with PV19, which is the violet. The V means the violet, isn't it? The purple. PV42 PR209 being the red. I know that. I think I do. Or use Rose of Ultramarine with Viridian. Ooh. Or Imperial Purple with Viridian. You know what? And that's it. There's mixing. That's why we want all of those colours, so we can mix. Yes. Oh, look, all of this is just fantastic. I love this. John, hello. Nice to see you, mate. Nice. Hello, Chrissy and everyone. Hope you're well. Sorry. No, you're fine. But I wish. Oh, no. It's nice to see you here, dear friend. Hope all is well on your side of the fence. Rob says, Chrissy, I'm halfway through a documentary on an artist that I personally hadn't heard of. Maybe some of you have. The program is on YouTube. Shall I share a link in the Facebook group? Yes, by all means, go ahead. Share away. Vivian, hello, how you going? Hope you are well, my dear. Dave says, Auntie Anne says, oh, g'day, Auntie Anne. Hello, how you going? We're going to come and visit you soon. Dave is going to give you a call. We talked about you. I hope your ears are burning. Oh, maybe your ears were burning. I don't know. He was saying, we have to make a trip to go up to Uncle Dave. I said, okay, let's do it. So expect a visit soon. I don't know when though. Yes. Yes, John, we've missed you. Exactly right. All right, so. Oh, and that's black. I don't want black. I do not want black. And I just wanted to also talk about Patreon. If you can see the top right hand corner up the top is the, it's not so much the link, but it tells you that I am on Patreon. For those who again stumbling on me and don't know, I paint a lot of surreal things, but I also paint, they're all real, and realistic things as well. So so you can head on over there if you like and become a patron. I do step by step, real time, you'll see one of the days is a tutorial day, and the other day and the other session is you seeing me work on a personal project. And I teach you more, not so much, I don't teach you so much, I influence you. I help you with your confidence and build your confidence, and we do projects. And the projects that we do, they're not, I'm not saying that they're difficult, but, you know, they do push you a little bit. I do try to push you a little bit, and we do simple stuff. You know, I've got a few simple projects there, but it's more the confidence. And which leads me to tell you about this and every, and I've got three tiers. So I've got a one-on-one. I've also got the one which is probably the most popular, where I live stream, and very intimate. Actually, the lessons are very intimate, and sounds funny the way I say it like that, but yeah, they are, and very one-on-one, and I talk about everything that I do and talk about the way I think, and, you know, tips and tricks and stuff like that that you may not have even thought of. So I do that. I show you things like that. And even the smaller tier, the smaller tier I have is I upload a concept or a reference photo with line art for projects once a month. So I do that as well, which leads me to believe, which leads me to tell you about this project. I will upload the line art to this. If you wanted to do this yourselves, this is something that you want to do on your own, of course. So I will upload the line art to this painting and the reference. So if you wanted to do this on your own, it's not a tutorial, but it's, if you wanted to do it on your own, you could. Thank you so much, Janice. Thank you so much. Hang on. I think I've missed a few things. Here we go. Let me go up the top. Okay. Ali says, Chrissy, then you get your moon glow. Okay. Oh, hang on. There's more. Ali says, Chrissy, a light fast alternative would be to replace. Oh, no, we've talked about that one. Oh, no, we haven't. Oh, no, we have talked about that one. Okay, and then you get your moon glow. Oh, okay, so you're combining all of those. That's wonderful. So she says, Chrissy, you can combine your light fast version of it out of the main individual components, Viridian, Ultramarine, and can replace the fugitive PR177 with what Ali suggests. Okay, wonderful. You don't have to, you don't have to apologize, John. You're good. You're all good. Okay, so hang on. I've got to keep on moving, doing. Okay. Rob says, Chrissy. Oh, no, we've done that one. I've gone down. Sorry. Silke, hello. There's another enabler, Silke. She is an enabler. She is worse than all of us put together. I think between Avigail and Silke, I think they're the main offenders. Oh, Angelina, the main offenders. They're the three. The three main enablers of the group, for sure. You missed it before, Silke. We were talking, yeah, but anyway, but yes. Yeah, so, but that was funny. Yes. We've got a chat full of enablers. The main event, that's right. But you're a yeah, that's right, Angie, the three amigos, that's what they are. Oh,
Yes,
I would agree. And you know what? You've got the best, like you have the best ideas too. The best ideas. Oh dear. Interesting when all you do is I tried in this area here, I tried to show there was underneath the mushroom, like there was I don't know what you call it, like a little hood. The fact that you can make one little mark makes such a difference. Yeah, and I don't want to spoil it either by doing that. Yeah, there you go. Of course I'm going to be doing pastel pencil with all of this, but this is all just all blocking in. Yeah. All right. And you know what? And I'm so glad you are enablers, because how will we find things? If someone, you know, there's always someone will find something. See, look, there you go. I just did that little stroke there, and look how it made such a difference. Yeah, there we go. All right. Oh, I've got to do this one here too. Here we go. And and I also wanted to mention the images that I've used here are from Pixabay, by the way. Of course, this grabbed my attention, the mushies. Abigail says, Chrissy, I also like making my own stuff. Yes, I know you do. And I have bought body shimmer and mixed it with watercolor. The results was amazing. Oh, body shimmer. Okay. What is body shimmer? Is that the stuff that you apply on your skin? Is that what it is? Like, you know, with makeup and you see those people where they brush on, like the models, and they brush on that shimmer. Well, models, anyone. Is it? Sergio says, more like three shopping wise men. Oh, that came out of left field. That's pretty good. That brings us the gifts of sales, coupons, and new arrivals. Oh, look, that is so funny, Sergi. Oh, you made me laugh. You made me laugh. That is so funny. Did I mention that I received more polymer clay yesterday? There you go. See, this is what I mean. Oh, I don't think I... Oh. And you've been doing some wonderful stuff too, Silke. Oh, that's hilarious. Very funny. Very funny. Yes. Okay, Abigail. Yes, it is. Right. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Ali says, Chrissy, PR. Which is the red, isn't it? A red is the actual vermilion pigment, which is toxic because it comes from cinnabar, which contains mercury. It is a warm red, almost a bright orange in mass tone. Wow. Ali, are you a member of Share Your Art with Xrissart? This would be really good stuff to be putting on in the Facebook group. Yes, Janice. Yeah. Oh, yeah. It looks like so much fun. Oh, yes. It does, doesn't it? The polymer clay. Jelena says, I was looking on Jackson's before the stream. Black Friday deals. You should all take a look. See, that's what I mean. There you go. And the good thing is that we're spread out. We've got Silke here in Australia in the Southern Hemisphere. We've got and we've got Abigail in Europe, like in the Netherlands, and of course Jelena in the UK. So we're all kind of like spread out, and they just hone in and bring us all together with all of these fantastic deals. Cherry says, yeah, I went to an exhibition and an artist there used clay on top of a painting for people. It was effective. Oh, wonderful. It's interesting. And Silke says, yes, but it is too hot here at the moment. The clay is too soft. I ordered harder clay, the one people say is so hard. And here it is like butter. Yes, because Silke lives in Queensland. It's warm there. Very warm. Yep. Yeah. Here we go. Using my small brush to go into small areas. How about that? Okay. I've drawn my mushrooms, three of them. Ho. A mother, father, and child. I made them up, of course, ready for painting. There you go, Jelena. See? Now you know what to paint. Yes. I like it when we help each other. Rumus, hello. Hello. Hi, Chris. Love your show. Oh, thank you so much. That's nice of you to say that. Thank you so much. I haven't seen you before. I don't think I've seen you before. So welcome. Okay, question, Rob says. Question, please. Has anyone heard of the artists William Bugero? Sorry, I can't spell his last name. Not sure? Not sure for me. I don't know. John says, Chrissy and everyone, have you ever been away from art for a while and then get apprehensive to start again because you feel you may have forgotten so much? You know what, John? That is a fair question. That is a fair question to ask. And I do understand. And then there's like an element of fear, isn't there, sometimes? You think, oh, look, I used to do some really fantastic stuff. I haven't done it for a while. Will I be able to pick up where I left off? You know, you won't know unless you pick up that pencil and do it. That is all I'm going to say. You won't know until that happens. So I say, go for it, mate. No one has to see what you're doing. It's only you and the pencil and you and the surface and your artwork. So I say, whatever it is, just do it. Because this is what happened to me when I was a young girl. I used to paint and draw a lot. When I say young girl, I'm talking like in my teens and stuff like that. And then I didn't pick it up until, you know, like in my later life. And I was worried, the same thing, you can imagine. My youngest boy, who also one of my boys paints and draws, and he just started drawing. And one time I remember, and I know I've said this story before, said, oh, and I used to, and he drew SpongeBob. He was watching a cartoon and he paused it and he wanted to draw SpongeBob. And it was so realistic. Like, he would have been about 8,
right?
He did such a fantastic job. And I used to say to him, I go, sweetheart, did you know that I used to paint and draw? And he was quite surprised because he'd never seen me do that. And then he pestered me for such a long time. And so he pestered me for, I'm talking months and months and months, long time. And so that's when I said to him, all right, go get your gear and we'll sit and we'll draw something. And it was Toy Story. It was Buzz and Woody. It was one of his books at the time. And I just started drawing. I thought, oh, I wonder if I can do this. Lo and behold, I did. So that is what I'm trying to tell you. No one has to say, well, my son was the one that saw this, but no one else saw this. So that's what I'm trying to say. I think that you should just go ahead. And if it doesn't turn out, well, it doesn't turn out. Who's going to know? Who's going to see? You know? So I say go for it. In a nutshell, go for it. Ali says, Chrissy, on Jackson's... Okay, on Jackson... I better just... Got to keep on working. On Jackson's... Okay, on Jackson's website, Michael Harding... Oh, hasn't he got beautiful oil paints? Michael Harding has got beautiful oil paints. Sells genuine Chinese vermilion colour in their oil paint. It costs... Yeah, six... Yeah, I know. And expensive. Yes. Michael Harding would have one of the most beautiful, I mean, there's a lot of oil paint brands that I like, but Michael Harding, beautiful, beautiful colors and beautifully made, but expensive. I know, they're just too much money. I can't justify that. Not when I've got all this other stuff that I buy all the time. But yes, thank you for that. I like that. Okay. John, it's like riding a bike. There you go. Abigail says it's like... Exactly right. It's like riding a bike. Yes. And Nolani says, yes, John. Yes, John. That's why I didn't do... any art for 25 years, been wanting to for years, but always telling myself I don't have the supplies I need, I can't think of what to do, and yeah, and so forth and so forth. Exactly. Just go ahead and do it. You know, go ahead. What's the worst that can happen? Truly. Hang on, I'm going off screen here. Here we go. Here we go. And Marcy says, yes, I am facing that now. I keep putting it off till I feel better, but I don't think I feel better till I get back to it. Yeah. But even if you're not painting, like maybe you could be looking at images to inspire you. And that takes a long time too, like, you know, trying to find the right image for you to paint too. And it doesn't, you know, the simpler the better. Need to say goodbye. Okay, thank you so much, Ali. It was very nice, and thank you for all of that valuable information. Love it so much. We'll see you next time. How about that? Oh, and Chandri's going. Okay, I need to go now. Have a nice stream. Okay, Chandri, thank you so much, my darling, for popping in. It was so nice to see you here as well. Hope to see you next time. Yeah. It's late in the UK, isn't it? And it's late in Europe. when I say late, is it like early hours of the morning? Like it's 9 o'clock, 9 a.m. here. What time is it in the UK? Or what time is it in Europe? What about you, Abigail? It's late for you too, isn't it? And thank you so much for everyone being here. Like it's just, it's so nice that we can chat and talk about lots of things. I better paint this one here too. John says, Chrissy, you have always been an inspiration to me. Oh, thank you so much. But you all inspire me too. Chrissy, not as late now that the time has changed. Okay, Janice. Yep. Okay, 11 o'clock in the Netherlands. You're a night owl, I know that much. And 10 p.m. in the UK. Okay, cool. All right, Rob, yep, gotcha. In Germany, okay, so it's the same, isn't it, as it is in the Netherlands, yeah. John says, yep, 2200. It is barely past midnight for me, folks, still transcribing my darn letters. Okay. And we're distracting you, which is a nice distraction, I hope, Sergio. Okay, cool. Okay, Silke, nice to see you here. Thanks for popping in. Netherlands and Germany is the same time zone. Okay, gotcha. I'm going to see if I can get most of this done because next week I want to tackle her. But the fabric part, I'm actually going to do that on Patreon. But all of the other bits here I'll do here. But the fabric part of her, I'm going to do on Patreon. Okay, Sergio says it is the best distraction. Thank you. Nalani says 4 p.m. here. Okay. I mean, even here in Australia, I'm on the East Coast, and there's about, now that we've gone for, there's about 4 hours difference. I think it all depends with daylight saving. I can't keep up. Yeah. Now it's good that we're all inspired by each other. I like that. I like that we inspire each other. Yes. And we come up with ideas and so many projects that we've done, and, you know, when I'm talking about getting inspired, some things that, some suggestions that we make for each other or when we have led to some really successful, some successful art pieces and we've learnt things from it. So I just love all of that. Like I just, you know, that's just like, can I say the biggest turn on? If the biggest art turn on. There we go. That's what it is. Yeah. I'm not going to, I'm just trying to decide whether I should take that off. Does it matter? Oh, gosh. Do you see what I mean? Like, this is the light coming from this way, so the shadows are there, see? That's what I'm doing. Geez, the minute you do that, it changes, doesn't it? When you just do one stroke. That's all it took. One little stroke. Yeah. Yep. There's a lot that has to be done here. As you can see from the reference, a lot has to be done. Let's see if I can paint this in, seeing as I've taken Cherry says, I love the way you say it doesn't matter if we mess up. Think that is what put me off for so long. Did I miss something? I wouldn't. I love the way you say it doesn't matter if you make a mess. That's right. Okay. Yeah, I know. I know, Cherry, but you know, exactly. What's the worst? What's the worst that could happen? Okay, I think I need my small brush here. Okay. Using this brush makes it so easy. For details, that is. Because I do use the sponges. I do use the sponges. Here we go. I use everything, anything and everything. Anything that's going to give me the result that I want. No rules. There are no rules. Abigail says, okay, it is getting so cold in the Netherlands. Please, somebody send us some warm sunshine. Here we go. Okay. Well, yes. I'm so glad it's warming up for us. And you've got a whole like 3 months of this, maybe more, Abigail. Okay, 13 degrees centigrade. Oh my gosh, that is so cold. Oh. Okay. Janice says, Abigail, really? What was the temperature? Oh yeah, okay. Yes. Because it's cold in the northern hemisphere, isn't it? Yeah. What, Janice? It was -4 this morning and frost everywhere. Oh, gosh. Well, I'm glad it's warming up here because I'm sick and tired of wearing jumpers and jackets and having to take jackets with me. Yeah, done with that. Dee says, we had our first snow today. What? Thankfully, just, oh my gosh. Snow already. Wow. I suppose, well, and because and our friend Anne, who lives in Finland, I saw a photo, and she was already like in parkas and stuff like that. And I'm thinking, oh, and this was like a while ago, like it could have been maybe, I don't know, three or four weeks ago. And I saw, and I'm thinking, oh my gosh, is it cold there already? And I thought to myself, wow. So, yeah. Cherry said, we had a balmy 15 degrees today, but gradually cooling down. Wow. Wow. And Jenna says, yeah, believe it or not, I love it. Yeah, she does. Don't you? Yes, I know you love it. Calls me the snow woman. Yeah, well, that's what you are, the snow queen. The snow queen. Janice, the snow queen. Okay. D says, I have been watching, but took a bit of time out for video call from grandkitties. Oh, how are they going? I hope they're going well. Yes. Thank you for coming back, D. So, again, I also wanted to mention, I'll be mentioning it a few times before before the year is out, I'm going to be doing a landscape. It's not a competition, okay? A landscape challenge, shall we say? Remember how we did the portrait one? Well, I'm going to announce all the details for the landscape one, but it's not now. It's going to happen, God willing, in the new year. So if you could get your thinking caps on and thinking about, you know, what you'd like to paint, and it's going to be the Xrissart landscape artist challenge. Yeah, so think about what you'd like to paint and if you'd like to join in. But when the time comes, you don't have to let me know now, but I just thought I'd, generate some interest, if you like. And so you'll, so you've got an idea whether you want to have a go. So that's happening, probably come out just after the new year, I would say. Okay, they are doing great. Oh, that's fantastic, D. Actually, just spent 4 days with them. They are Oma and Opa's best buddies for now. 4 years old and 16 months, of course. Of course, that's a really lovely age, isn't it? When they're just starting to talk and have a conversation with you and they say things funny and stuff like that. Yeah, I think that's so cute. Okay, Abigail says, you're going to hibernate, are you? You're going to hibernate. Not a bad idea. Yep. Okay. Yes, Abigail. Yeah, it is such a sweet age, isn't it? Okay, our cold weather usually kicks in after Christmas. Okay, gotcha. All right. Rob says, I once did a landscape in coloured pencil and it looked worse than a 3-year-old drawing. Rob, I still have it in my folder of shards. Oh, seriously. Remember everything. If you feel that it wasn't what you wanted, if you learnt something, then it was a success. Do you know what I mean? So I always look at it from the positive side. Always look at it from the positive side. Janice says, I used to always be cold when I was younger, but now I enjoy it. As long as you're dressed for it, it's not so bad. I know. The Snow Queen has spoken. Okay, Jelena says, I'm painting my mushrooms while listening. Of course, that is, see? It's all about getting your creative juices going. And so glad you're doing it. You'll have to share. You'll have to share, Jelena, okay? Oh, you don't have to share, but it would be nice for you to share. Okay, Janice, I look like, Abigail says, Janice, I look like the Michelin man, so many layers I wear and still I'm cold. Yes. You know what's funny? I know the Michelin man. He's very famous, isn't he? Gosh. I know the Michelin man, okay. Jenna says, I bet you look cute. Yes. Okay, it depends where you are in the UK. The north gets quite a lot of snow, but in the south only sometimes. The coldest recently was five below, okay? But usually around freezing. Wow. Yes, in the northern part, isn't it? Because the closer you are to the equator, the warmer it is, isn't it? Yep. Okay. Rob says, yes. At the same time, I was very embarrassed of that drawing, but I did learn. See, that's the main thing, mate. Yep. Oh, don't you worry. I've got ones that I've... I posted one for our Remembrance Day, and it was an oil painter that I did, like, I don't know, when I picked up painting all those years ago, more than 10 years ago, and I look at it a little bit and I'm thinking, oh, I'm cringing a little bit with some of that stuff, but I am proud of it because I learnt things. I certainly did learn. And that was around the time that I was picking up pastels as well. So yes, it was the two soldiers, and then there was the poppies, and the poppy fields and stuff like that. But yeah, it wasn't a masterpiece, so to speak, but it was something that the subject was something that I liked. Cherry, you've just ordered snow boots, as my feet are always cold. Oh my god, are they like UGG boots? You call them snow boots in the UK? Are they like UGG boots? You know, the ones where they've got the sheepskin on the inside and the fur on the inside. Well, it's not real fur, but that faux fur, and we call them UGG boots here. Is that what you call snow boots there? And Angie says, yeah, loved it. Oh, thank you so much, Angie. It was a very thoughtful pick. Thank you so much, Angie. Okay. Yes, Cherry, I always take warm water bottled with me to warm my feet. Oh, yeah, like a hot water bottle? Hot water bottle. Yeah. Rob says, yeah, I seen that painting and I thought it was great. Oh, thank you so much, Rob. Yeah. That paint, yeah. It's, yeah. So do you know what I mean now, Rob? So it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. I don't think you should be hard on yourself. I don't think we should be hard on, like, here's me. what is it? Do as I say, not as I do. We should, as artists, we shouldn't be hard on each other. Yeah, what is it? Yeah. Oh. I know we are hard on each other, but we shouldn't be. We should not be hard on each other. Now this is mainly, this should be mainly cream, but I had to add in the darks before I went really light. So I just thought I'd mention why I'm doing it the way I'm doing it. Okay. You've got UGG boots too. Snow boots are just fleecy lined. Okay. All right. Yeah. All right. Okay. John says, Chrissy, I remember that painting and so beautiful and emotional too. Yes. Oh, gosh. And they had a, well, it was commemorating Remembrance Day. And, of course, they had a, on television during the day, they had like a service here in Australia. And I'm sure all over many parts of the world have this, this is also recognised. And, of course, they were having a service. And, of course, I'm bawling my brains out. I'm just bawling my brains out. Like, oh, I get so emotional. I get so emotional. I used to get emotional even when I was a like a young girl. Now even more so because my boys are in the Australian Defence. Even more so now. And sometimes like I can't watch it. Like I get like it's so, yeah. Like I get emotional from pride. Do you know what I mean? Like it's pride. It's I don't know the feel. Can't explain the feelings in words. My vocabulary doesn't allow me to express how emotional I get with things like that. Well, as you know, I do get sooky anyway, but yeah. Oh, and you love that painting too. Thank you, Cherry. Thank you so much. Nolani says, I've been thinking about the landscape I want to do. Ooh. I think I may try acrylics again. Ooh. Very good. Very good. Very good. And Angie says, my husband needs to subscribe. I think he missed you, Chrissy. he is all concerned I was going to miss you. Oh dear. Well, you say g'day to him from me. All right, Angie. Okay. And Rob says, oh, sorry. Abigail says, Rob, when I don't like my art, I think of Hunter Biden's art and he is selling it for so much money.
Really?
That's right. I agree, Rob. Of course. You are, yes. You're an awesome artist, Abigail. I love the latest one that you did with the gouache. I love your characters. They're cute. Okay. Angie, done. Yes. Yeah. All right. Yes. So think of what you would like, because sometimes like you need a bit of a thought process, like yeah, landscape. Look, seascapes are included in this, but yeah, seascape, landscape. What else? Urban scape. Yes, all of those would be included.
All of those would be included. And sometimes, like, you know, you need some time to think about it, and you can have a bit of a head start, because the deadlines on those ones are firm, okay? So they are firm, because they have to be judged. I haven't asked Will yet, but I'm going to ask him if he could judge that as well for us. He doesn't know yet. I haven't asked. I will. But yeah, our friend Will. All right. Okay. Well, I don't think I've done too much. I've done a lot of talking. I know I've done a lot of talking, but I have done a bit of painting. So, you know, bits and pieces here and there. So let's just pull this away. Here we go. All right. So here she is. We're still got lots to go. I'm calling it a stream. And I just wanted to see what else have we got here before I go. The media, yeah. Okay. Rob says, I'm in tons of Facebook groups, so I don't see much art and much as wood turning when I go on Facebook. Okay. Cherry says, I need to think about the landscape one. I've been trying to work out Photoshop all afternoon. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Okay. Yes. Yep. All right. Okay. Well, I wanted to say thank you all so much. You guys are awesome. I'm going to be here the same time next week. I think I'll stick to this time. And every now and again, oh, Horsewoman, hello, how are you going? I can't believe it's time to go already. Well, it goes really fast, doesn't it, when you're sitting and chatting? But yeah, look, I will be here again, same time, you know, every now and again, who knows, I might pop up and do a little pop-up stream. At the moment, I've got a lot going on, but you just don't know. Please, if you could, thumbs up and share, and it helps the channel. And I just want to say how grateful and to be amongst you wonderful people, and to be surrounded with like-minded people such as yourselves. I am so honored to be your friend. I know, Horsewoman, sorry, bummer. Yeah, just got home. All right then, everyone, thank you so much, and I'll talk to you again next week. Okay, and don't forget, share your art with Xrissart. Post all your conversations in there as well. But anyway, thank you all so much. And thank you, Janice.